after so many reports and newspaper readings, we found out that the death rates in rural areas were more as compared to urban areas. And we have read that the availability of doctors are also very less compared to the urban areas. Even though doctors are available or allotted in the government hospitals, they are not ready to treat those people in rural areas. So we try to implement such an idea so that it will help the rural people to get medical care and improve their living conditions. This is our patient side app. We had to log in using our login credentials, and we had to enter our contact number, age and sex. Once we log in, now the doctor is shown as online as he is available on his phone. He had two options here, one is for regular checkup and the other is for diagnosis. Now in the diagnosis tab, we have the symptom checker. We had to check mark the symptoms that are available and that we are facing. If the symptoms are not listed, you can enter it using the other symptoms option. Now let's check mark the symptoms and plus continue. Now the machine will start diagnosis. The values will be measured. And the blood pressure is, well, pulse is known as 87 BPM. We can measure the height using the ultrasonic sensor. It measures the total height and minuses the height of the person from here. So that's how the height sensor works. Now let's move on to the blood pressure. We can use this blood pressure sensing module to measure the blood pressure. Now the blood pressure is being displayed. Now let's move on to the next parameter. That is the blood glucose level. Now the blood glucose is measured using an Aceton sensor. That is a non-intuitive method of measuring the glucose. We have to just blow through the sensor and it will predict whether we are diabetic or not using three levels, that is high, medium and low. Now his glucose level is shown as normal. Now let's move on to the next parameter. That's the weight. This is a weight sensor module below here. The weight has been measured and it's 67 kilograms. Now we can view the result using the view result tab. So these are the result of our measurement values. Here the values that you have measured and here are the remarks. Now we can send to the doctor. Now the data is being sent to the doctor. We have our doctor's app here. We had to log in using the doctor's login credentials. And now he can view the number of patients in queue, that is 66. And now he can begin the diagnosis. He can view the first patient that is in queue. And his phone number is age, sex, and the percentage of disease prediction that is given by the machine. His vitals that have been measured are displayed here. And the symptoms that you are facing is being displayed here. Now, if the values are not so enough for the doctor to predict, we have an option to video call the patient directly so that he can get or collect more values. If he is satisfied with the report, he can click the submit report button and he can type in the report for the patient. Once the report is being sent, he can prescribe the medicine. He can check box the medicine that is available inside the app. From the patient side app, we can click on the continue button and the doctor's report is being displayed here and the prescription is being shown in this tab. Now we can dispatch the medicine as per the availability inside the machine. The patient can click on the dispatch medicine button and the medicine will then be dispatched.
Our basic aim is to help the society with what we study. And with this project, we were able to help the people in the rural area. So it gives us much satisfaction.
Sir, the basic and first challenge that we faced by us is about the serial communication. We faced many troubles with the serial communication. Sometimes the data may not receive the. So after that, by knowing about the handshake and about other communication principles, we implemented them. Then we resolved that issue. Then the next issue we faced was the server to Android communication. We are getting many errors in the initial stages, but finally we all resolved all them.
Time was really an issue for us. In between the competition, we had our university exams. So we learned a lot about time management.
In the initial stage of the project, we thought that we can implement it by using Python language, by using a PyQt interface and all. But when we approached the vendor, he says that use Android for this, use a tablet for this. But at that time, I'm not much familiar with that of the Android Studio and all. From there, he motivated me to learn the Android and how it works. so that I take it as a challenge, and within few days I think I can write a better code in Android right now. Okay, most of the more than 75% of the Android I have learned by using this project, because it includes everything, having a Bluetooth communication, serial communication we learned, and also how to communicate the network, server side, database, everything we learned by these projects.
Idea competition is a great opportunity for every student to improve his skills and to identify what he is capable of doing. Actually, we had no idea on how to implement this, but we were made to implement, or we were in a spirit to implement our idea. Actually, we have learned a lot, and now it's an inspiration for us to work on more projects.